I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Charles, you're a boxing trainer. If I wanted to do weights, to have stronger arms, to punch harder, what's like the basic drill you would recommend fighters?
Well, it wouldn't be one exercise. It would be a variety of exercises in which you work your way to work your body evenly, not creating an imbalance somewhere, right?
You don't want to just have huge biceps?
No, you don't want to just have huge biceps. And you know I'm a big proponent of strength and conditioning. Some trainers, it might as well be the Black Plague. I mean, they don't have their fighters touch a weight. I'm not one of those guys. I think that you get a tremendous amount of benefit from really strengthening your body.
So right now, if you had a fighter that you want to increase his strength, what's one drill you would show him? There is
like
not one.
Yeah, you gotta evenly work your entire body. You know, the king of all exercises.
Push-ups, pull-ups, like
maybe the deadlift.
What's a deadlift?
Deadlift is.
Is that what they do in the Olympics?
Yeah, you literally just pick a bar off the ground from a dead position. No, not over your head, just from locking out.
One in, one out?
And they say, you know, exercise physiologists will tell you that this exercise alone activates the most muscle fibers in the entire body.
Yeah. What about bench press? Do you recommend that?
In an overall strength training scheme, absolutely. You know, it's not the only exercise I do, but yeah, pushing exercises, absolutely. And the bench press is an excellent pushing exercise.
If I'm going to say what's more important, shoulder or forearms for power, what would you answer? Now,
what do you think I'm going to answer?
It's all the same. It's balance.
Yeah, you got to have, exactly. You have to have strong forearms and shoulders.
There's not one thing that's more important than the other that could make you hit harder, bro.
There's not, and thinking
strong
that
leg?
Way is the wrong way to think. Thinking that way is going to get you imbalanced. Thinking that way is going to have you put too much emphasis in one area and not enough in other areas.
So when we see fighters ripped and yoked out like crazy, what goes through your mind when you see it? Like, is it natural? Have they worked on it, or?
Well, fighters train extremely hard, right? So in that way, you can always know it's a testament to their gym time. But certain physiques are too muscle bound, and you know that it's just not going to work well for boxing. But some guys somewhat break the rules that way. AJ, you know, he has that kind of physique that you wouldn't expect to be productive for boxing, but it is.
It works for him.
How about Arthur Beterbiev? That guy looks like a weightlifter, right? But he's
Better
a very
Baev.
Powerful guy.
Yes.
Beterbiev, I'm sorry.
Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ES News. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition, he abusing them.